James Marcias does have evidence that there is a developmental trend for these four kinds of identity statuses. For diffusion and foreclosure, both of these are really not thinking things through when you're experiencing a crisis. Moratorium and achievement are where we're experiencing a crisis and thinking things through. Across the bottom here on the x-axis, we have age. On the y-axis, we have percent in each identity status. As you can see, younger adolescents are more likely to give rationales that place them into categories of identity diffusion and foreclosure. They aren't really thinking through their crises. As people get older, though, they're increasingly likely to give rationales that place them in categories of moratorium or identity achievement. And during the teen years and early 20s, the greatest increase in identity type is for identity achievement, which is the blue line. So, as people get to 16, 17, 18 years of age, they are just starting to think through their issues carefully and just starting to commit to some of these changes, but it's a small percentage. Most teens have a diffused identity, even at 18. But by the time people get to 24 years of age, most will have reached identity achievement. It's worth noting that at the age of 18, people are allowed to generally vote or join the military, where they're legally considered to be an adult in a lot of places. You can see here that, at that age, most adolescents still don't really have their own identity. They're still working things through, but they are able to commit to important things even before they really know who they are. The long and short of this is that forging one's own identity is a long process, in contemporary societies anyway. Not until around 21 years of age do a majority of adolescents get to the achievement or moratorium status. We might have different identity statuses in different areas of our lives. So our love life versus our work versus how we deal with religion or whatnot, we might have different identities in all of those different areas of our life. Identity achievement has been associated with some good things, things like being open-minded. When we've made a decision about who we want to be, sometimes it helps to consider a different point of view. Identity achievement is also associated with high self-esteem and psychological well-being.